Three ways to shift from indulgence to independence. On Monday mornings, we're all faced with a difficult choice. Get up a few minutes early to brew your own coffee, or sleep a little later and then whip through a drive-thru for your morning pick-me-up? When that caffeine hits your bloodstream, how you got the coffee may not matter too much. But the next time you go through a drive-thru for that cup of joe, picture your financial strategy shouting and waving its metaphorical arms to get your attention. Why? Each and every time you indulge in a luxury that has a less expensive alternative, you're potentially delaying your financial independence. Delay it too long and you might find yourself working when you should be enjoying a comfortable retirement. Sound dramatic? Alarmist? Apocalyptic? But that's how it happens. One $5 peppermint mocha at a time. This isn't to say that you can't enjoy an indulgence every once in a while. You gotta treat yourself sometimes, right? Just be sure that you're sticking with your overall long-term strategy. Your future self will thank you. Here are three ways to shift from indulgence to independence. Number one, make coffee at home. Reducing your expenses can start as simply as making your morning coffee at home. And you might not even have to get up earlier to do it. Why not invest in a coffee pot with a delay brewing function? It'll start brewing at the same time you preset. And what's a better alarm clock than the scent of freshly brewed coffee waiting from the kitchen or from your bedside table? A quick Google search will yield numerous lists of copycat specialty drinks that you can make at home. Number 2. Work out at home. A couple of questions to ask yourself. Will an expensive gym membership fit into your monthly budget? How often have you gone to the gym in the last few months? If your answers are somewhere between no and I'd rather not say, then maybe it's time to ditch the membership in favor of working out at home. Or perhaps you're a certified gym rat who faithfully wrings every dollar out of your gym membership each month. Then ask yourself if you really need all the bells and whistles that an expensive gym might offer. Elliptical, dumbbells, and machine with clearly printed how-tos? Yes, of course. But a hot tub, sauna, and an out-of-pocket juice bar? Maybe not. If you can get in a solid workout without a few of those pricey extras, your body and your wallet will thank you. Instead of using a treadmill inside a gym, take a walk or jog around your local park each day. It's free. If you prefer to work out at a gym, look into month-to-month membership options instead of paying a hefty price for a year-long membership upfront. Number 3. Ditch cable and use a video streaming service instead. Cable may give you access to more channels and more shows than ever before, but let's be honest, who has time to watch 80 hours of the greatest moments in sports every week? Asking yourself if you could cut the cable and wait a little longer for your favorite shows to become available on a streaming service might not be a bad idea. Plus, who doesn't love using a 3-day weekend to binge-watch an entire series every now and then? There's also the bonus of how easy it is to cancel or reactivate a streaming service. With cable, you may be locked into a multi-year contract. Installation can be a hassle, and they may add an extra installation fee. And you can forget about knowing when the cable guy is actually going to show up. Plenty of streaming services offer free trial periods. Go ahead and give them a try, but be careful. You may have to enter your credit card number to access the free trial. Don't forget to cancel before your trial is over, or you will be charged. Taking time to address the luxuries you can live without or enjoy less often has the potential to make a huge impact on your journey to financial independence. Cutting back here and investing in yourself there, it all adds up.